Welcome you all in the presentation of hydroelectric power, which is part of water resource engineering and hydrology subject. And I want to mention you that this topic is for civil engineering branch students. So same topic will be discussed in mechanical engineering students in different way. And this is basic introductory topic, or I can say video, for civil engineering students, right? I am Srupti Pandya from Mahatma Gandhi Institute of Technical Education and Research Center, Navsari. So let's start with the contents. Content of this video are the classification of hydroelectric plants, like low head plant, medium head plant, high head plant. Other classification is also there. Then the component of the powerhouse and hydro schemes, and the small topic of merits and demerits of hydroelectric power. So first of all, let's briefly introduce about hydroelectric power. Is a power derived from energy of falling water, which may be harnessed for useful purpose. Since ancient time, hydro power has been used for irrigation and for the operation of various mechanical devices such as water mills, show mills, textile mills, dock cranes, and domestic lifts. So energy of water can be used for different purposes. So this is one schematic and very simple diagram to basic information of hydroelectric power. So it consists of penstock and a powerhouse, these two things. And the mechanical component is turbine. So let's see in detail. When what is the system of power generation in hydroelectric powers generation scheme? This slide explain you in terms of engineering, in terms of energy, how the system is work. Hydropower generation system is work. So our aim is to generate electricity. Now first topic or first point explain you how electricity will generate. When a coil is rotated in a magnetic field, electricity is generated. Thus, in order to produce electrical energy, it is necessary to produce mechanical energy, because we want to rotate the coil, and for rotation of coil we have to apply mechanical energy, right? So for mechanical energy is produced by running a turbine, and to run the turbine we want one more energy, whether we are using fuel or water. So here we are using water to rotate the turbine and thereby to generate mechanical energy. So thus, when the energy of flowing water is used to run the turbine, then the electricity generated is called hydroelectric power. So ultimately we want to rotate the coil, and for rotation of coil we require mechanical energy. And for means we have to rotate the turbine, and for the rotation of the turbine we are using water flow or flowing water energy, right? So this whole scheme is known as Heidel scheme, and the power station is known as Heidel power station or hydroelectric power station. So this is how the energy is generated. So here I, on right hand side, you can see water flow. That water flow impact on the blades of turbine. So due to this kinetic energy of water, with the help of that shaft, we can rotate the turbine. And rotation of turbine or the shaft is attached with the rotor of electrical part, and with the help of rotation of that rotor, we generate, or the generator generate, electric energy. In a hydropower scheme, a certain quantity of water at a certain potential head is essential, is made to flow through turbines. The head causing water runs the turbine blades and thus producing electricity from the generator coupled to the turbine. So all the systems are attached with other, with the help, so in general, with the help of kinetic energy of flowing water, first we will generate mechanical energy, and with the help of mechanical energy we generate electrical energy, right? So these are the classification of hydel plants, or run of river plant, storage plant, pump storage plant, and tidal plant. So these classification is based on hydraulic characteristics. Another classification is based on head, right? So run of river plant, storage plant, pump storage plant, and tidal power plants are the classification of hydropower in terms of hydraulic characteristics. Run of river plant are those which utilize minimum flow in a river that have no appreciable pondage on its upstream side. A weir or barrage is sometimes constructed across a river simply to raise the water level. Either slowly for the power plant or for some other purpose where the power plant may be incidental. Such a scheme is essentially a low head scheme and may be suitable only on a perennial river having sufficient dry weather flow. So this is small scale plant, we can say, in terms of that generation of power is very less. So in for such type of plants, we won't require huge dam. A weir or barrage can be constructed, means lower height dam is constructed, which is called as weir and barrage, and with the help of that small pondage or the reservoir, we generate few amount of or less amount of electricity. Like this, run of river plant. Okay, this type of plant is only constructed on perennial river, means river having dry weather flow. So this plant required throughout the year some amount of water without constructing dam or creating reservoir. Storage plant. A storage plant is essentially having an upstream storage reservoir, as we know, like this type of situation, right, of sufficient size as to permit sufficient carryover storage from the monsoon season to the dry summer season, and thus to develop a firm flow substantially more than the minimum natural flow. In this scheme, a dam is constructed across a river and the powerhouse may be located at the foot of the dam. So previous one is a smaller scale plant. This is large scale plant which generate more energy compared to run of river plant, and to generate more energy we want the heavy turbines, and for rotation of that huge turbine we want
high kinetic energy of water, and that high kinetic energy of water can be generated with the high flow of water, and the velocity of water can be increased by constructing large height dam. So with that height of, with the help of the height of the dam, we can get maximum velocity of flow, outflow water or kinetic energy. So for this scheme, we require dam like this, right? Pumped storage plant. Pumped storage plant generate power during peak hours, but during the off-peak hour, water is pumped back from the tailwater pool to the headwater pool, so that used water is again stored in the reservoir, pumped back. The pumps are run by some secondary power for some other plant in the system for the rotation of the, or for the working of pumps, we require other power source. The plant is thus preliminary meant for assistant and existing thermal power, sorry, thermal plant or some hydro plant. So for the running of pump, we required the power, and for that we have to construct another plant like this. The water from the reservoir flow from the penstock and generate electricity. Now from the tail water, the again water can be go back and store again. Tidal plants. Tidal plants for generation of hydroelectric power are recent and modern advancement, and essentially work on the principle that there is a rise in sea water during high tide period and fall during low tide period. The water rises and falls during the day. The advantage of these rise and fall is taken in the tidal plant. In other words, the difference between high and low tide level is utilized to generate power. So for explanation of tidal plant, this last point you have to remember. The high and low tide level is utilized for power generation. This is accomplished by constructing a basin separated from the ocean by a partition wall and installing turbine in the opening through the wall. So a tidal plant, obviously tides are generated in the ocean. So at such location, instead of dam, construct a wall on one side of ocean, so that wall provide head to the water through the openings in the walls. The water run the turbine and electricity will generate it. Water passes from the ocean to the basin drainage at high tide and thus running the turbine and generating electric power. During low tide, the water from the basin runs back to the ocean, which can again be utilized to generate the electric power for either direction. Such plants are useful where the tidal range is high, like this. Tide come in, tide going out. So in both the cases, the turbine rotate, and at the same both time we generate electricity. Classification of hydropower plant based on operating head of turbine. Another classification. Low head scheme means head of water, means the depth of water stored in the reservoir is less than 50 meter. Medium head scheme, head vary from 50 to 60 meter. High head scheme, the height or the depth of water stored is greater than 60 meter. A low head scheme is one which use water head
less than 50. And so run of river plant is under category of low head scheme. In this scheme of weir, or so we want a less height, so large dam is not required. By constructing weir or barrage, we can head up water up to 15 meter. So weir and barrage is constructed to raise the water level, and powerhouse is constructed either in continuation with the barrage at some distance downstream of the barrage, where water is taken to the powerhouse through an intake canal. Low barrage is provided with gates, and powerhouse is constructed nearby. Medium head means the head of water between 50 to 60. Dam is required. Dam height is not sustainable. Although the dam height is not substantial, this scheme features somewhere between low head scheme and low high head scheme. Medium head plant. High head plant. High head scheme is the one which uses water head more than 60 meter, and so a dam of sufficient height is therefore required, so as to store water on the upstream side and to utilize this water throughout the years. The common example of such dam are Bakra Dam in Punjab, Hoover Dam in USA. See, this is a dam with lightning and powerhouse over here, right, for power generation. Right, so these are the classification based on head and based on structure. Let's see the components. A hydroelectric development scheme ordinarily includes a diversion structure, a conduit to carry water to turbine and governing mechanism, generator, controls, switching apparatus, housing equipments, transmission lines, gates, forebays, tanks, and many more equipment. A channel from the powerhouse back to the river is constructed, and the powerhouse is situated such a place that the draft tube cannot discharge water directly into the river. So many components are there in hydroelectric scheme. The choice of particular type of plant at a given site depend on various factors. So we have around 6 different types of plants. Which type of plant is suitable for which location is depend on general topography of the area, available head, available flow, availability of other type of power station in the vicinity, and requirement of power for industry, and obviously the political influence. So many factors are affected the selection of type of plant. This is a schematic or inside view of hydropower plant. We will discuss each and every component of hydropower plant. Okay, the components are starting component is reservoir. This is the main component. Why it is main component? Because the whole system will work on the flow of water, velocity of water. If we are not getting high velocity of flow, the system will never run. Right. So how we will get the flow or velocity of water? By increasing the height. So when, if the height is more, if water flow from here to here, as the height is more, the velocity will be more, kinetic energy will be more, right? So the first and foremost component is reservoir and dam system. to get head of water. See, this is the head. Head of water. Right? Which gave kinetic energy. Okay. So, this is intake structure. First component, intake structure. Inside component, main part is reservoir and dam, whatever. Then first is intake structure. Intake structure is one type of screen. We will see in detail, but I just want to brief you in this figure only. So intake structure is one type of screen which reduce the or the protect the whole system from the debris and dust and dirt or sediments. Another structure is control gate, which control the entry of the flow whenever it is required, right? So gates are there. Then this is the most important component, penstock. Penstock is nothing but the pipe. What you can see, pipe which supply water from the reservoir to the structure. Another component is turbine. As we all know that the so the water directly flow to the turbine. So next is turbine. After rotating the turbine, we can rotate the generator. Generator is there. Now generator generate the electricity, and there is a transformer. We transfer the power to the power line, and this whole system is in the power house. Now the flowing water is now going back to the outflow channel. So this is steel race eighth component. And power line is not part of civil engineering, that's why we are not discussing over here. So these are the components. This is very simple system if you go through it once. Once you go through the system, you will get the whole idea and you can remember it easily. The major component of hydroelectric schemes are described below. The forebay. A forebay is a storage basin or any other large body of water situated in front of intake structure. Its main function is to temporarily store the water which is ejected by the plant due to reduced load during off-peak hour, and also to meet the instantaneous increased demand when the load is suddenly increased. The forebay therefore absorbs the short interval variation in water demand and corresponding fluctuation in power load. In many cases, canal lead the water to the turbine. Sometimes the power plant is away from the dam section. So in such cases, the water from the reservoir is flowing through the canal. So canal lead the water to the turbine. The canal itself can be large enough to absorb these flow variations. When the canal is long, its section is sometimes enlarged at the ends so as to provide necessary temporary storage. In many cases, when reservoir is constructed by building a dam and the water is taken to the powerhouse directly from the reservoir through penstock, the reservoir itself acts as a forebay. Right, so forebay is a one type of lake which is created in case of where the powerhouse is away from the dam section. In second case, if the powerhouse is just at the downstream of the dam section, then reservoir itself work or act as a forebay. So 4B is a storage reservoir, right? Which provide water to the penstock. So this is 4B, right? Which is constructed away from the dam section and which store the water for powerhouse only, right? The next components will be discussed in second video. Thank you.